Hello students, so let's start with today's biology class of class 12. Yesterday we have started with gametogenesis process, in which we have discussed about spermatogenesis, and today we will study oogenesis, which is the production of or synthesis of the mature ovum in females. As spermatogenesis is the process of formation of sperms, and here we will discuss the process of formation of ovum. So, oogenesis is the process which is quite different from spermatogenesis process. So, let's see here. First, this is the structure I have already shown you, the sectional view of ovary, which shows the different stages of oogenesis process. Similar to the testes, as it's the outermost layer of cells is called germinal epithelium. In this also the germinal epithelium is there. The cells of germinal epithelium will undergo development, division and differentiation to form mature ovum. And here these cells are called oogonia. They are called oogonia. Singular is oogonium. Okay. So there is an interesting fact about oogonia, that when the development of a female fetus takes place, I am talking about female fetus. During the development of female fetus, the ovary development will also takes place. At that time, the number of oogonia are decided, means all the oogonia in the ovary will be there, and they are present in millions. So, millions of oogonia are developed in the ovary of the female during its fetal life. So, here you can see in the fetal life, the number of oogonia are fixed. They are in millions. And these oogonia will undergo mitosis as well as differentiation process to form the cells which are called primary oocytes. They are called primary oocytes. So, this whole thing happens in the fetal life only, means when the development of the female fetus takes place, that time the oogonium will undergo mitosis and differentiation to form a number of cells which are called primary oocytes. Okay. So, these primary oocytes, they are also in millions because they are forming from oogonia. But before birth, many of the primary oocytes, they undergo degeneration. Not before birth, but till the birth of the female fetus or the female baby, the primary oocytes will be developed in the ovary. Are you getting my point? Means when the female fetal life develops, during the development of the female fetus, the oogonia are there, the development of oogonia will take place in the ovary, as well as mitosis and differentiation from oogonia will also takes place to form millions of primary oocytes. So, this primary oocytes, their number is fixed at the time of birth. They are around 4 lakhs. Okay. So, these primary oocytes, after the birth, they will actually undergo the further development to form the ovum. So, these primary oocytes after birth, but till you know that the ovum will start producing at the time of puberty. So, from birth till puberty, the primary oocytes in the ovaries will start degenerating, but not all. So, out of these 4 to 5 lakhs primary oocytes which were present at the birth, when they will reach at the stage of puberty, many primary oocytes will undergo degeneration. So, at the time of puberty, only 60,000 to 80,000 primary oocytes will be left in the ovary of the female, each ovary. Okay. So, is it clear? Ki first, kya hota hai? Oogonia jo hai, they have a fixed number at the time of fetal development, female fetal development. Then they undergo mitosis and differentiation to form primary oocytes. So, at the time of birth, the primary oocyte has their fixed number, 4 to 5 lakhs in each ovary. But when the female development will takes place, from birth till puberty, so many primary oocytes will undergo degeneration. So, how many will be left? 60,000 to 80,000. When the puberty will be attained, then the primary oocyte will undergo further processing to form mature ovum. So, when these primary oocytes undergo meiosis 1, as you know that meiosis will be happening here because to form the gamete, because to reduce the number of chromosomes. So, the primary oocytes will undergo meiosis 1 to form, and here I am showing you one cell only. One primary oocyte will undergo meiosis to form two cells. So, here you can see I have shown one smaller cell and one bigger cell. Why is that so? I will tell you. So, the smaller cell is called as polar body. It will undergo degeneration, and the bigger cell is called as secondary oocyte. Clear? So, primary oocyte will undergo meiosis 1 to form two cells. One is smaller in size called polar body, and second is bigger in size called secondary oocyte. And this polar body will undergo degeneration. Now, why is that so? Why the smaller cell and bigger cells are formed? Because you know that here the processing of ovum formation is taking place. And we are clear that after fertilization, when fusion of male and female gamete takes place, the zygote that is formed will have the cytoplasm of the female gamete only. Means jab zygote form hota hai to usme nucleus sperm aur ovum dono ka hota hai, lekin cytoplasm kiska hota hai? Only female ka. That is why here the karyokinesis will takes place as usual by reducing the number of chromosomes to half, but cytokinesis will not be equally divided. Means the cytoplasm is not equally divided. Very less cytoplasm will be given to the polar body, and most of the cytoplasm will be accumulated by secondary oocyte, because the secondary oocyte will further undergo development to form ovum, which will carry most of the cytoplasm for the further development of the fetus. Is it clear? Are you clear with my point? So, the first polar body, it is of no use. It is just formed to reduce the number of chromosomes in the secondary oocyte, that is 23. So, this will be degenerated. So, here you can see oogonia has 46 chromosomes. Primary oocyte has been formed from mitosis has 46, but secondary oocyte has 23 chromosomes. Now, what is the difference between the structure of primary and secondary? I will show you here. Now, this secondary oocyte will be arrested in this stage only. Means secondary oocyte ki development hone ke baad, at the time of puberty, the secondary oocyte stage will be retained. Further development will not take place, but it will take place when fertilization will occur. Is it clear? Ki jab puberty stage aayega, to secondary oocytes स्टेज तक ही वो अपने आप को अरेस्ट रखेंगे. फर्दर डेवलपमेंट, फर्दर प्रोसेसिंग तभी होगी जब उसमें फर्टिलाइजेशन होगी. मीन्स प्यूबर्टी के टाइम पे फीमेल हैज़ ओनली सेकेंडरी ओसाइट इन इट्स बॉडी, एंड एट द एडल्ट स्टेज दैट इज द रिप्रोडक्टिव लाइफ दैट विल बी कन्वर्टेड इन टू ओवम ओनली दैट टाइम वेन स्पर्म विल एंटर इन टू द फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव ट्रैक, एंड इन दिस इट विल बी अरेस्टेड एट द मेटाफेज स्टेज. मीन्स सेकेंडरी ओसाइट जो है वो मेटाफेज स्टेज तक डेवलपमेंट करेगा, उसके बाद वो स्टॉप हो जाएगा. ठीक है, उसके बाद मियोसिस टू होगा जब स्पर्म एंटर करेगा फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव ट्रैक में. मीन्स सेकेंडरी ओसाइट स्टेज पे ही ओव्यूलेशन हो जाती है. देन द ओवम विल बी फॉर्म्ड आफ्टर मियोसिस टू. सिमिलरली वन सेल विल फॉर्म टू, एंड वन ऑफ द सेल विल नॉट वेस्ट द साइटोप्लाज्म. इट विल फॉर्म द सेकेंड polar body that will be degenerated, and the second one will be converted into ovum. And how does it happens, we will discuss later. Now let me show you this diagram, you will be more clear. This is the germinal epithelium whose cells will act as oogonia during the fetal development, female fetal development. Next part is this oogonia will be converted into primary oocytes. So these cells are the primary follicles or primary oocytes. These are actually the primary follicle. This full structure is primary follicle, and the cell inside is primary oocyte. Is it clear? So, why it is called primary follicle? Because the primary oocyte is not present separately or lonely or independently, but it is covered with some layer of cells, and these cells are called granulosa cells. क्या बोलते हैं इनको? Granulosa cells. So, primary follicle is that structure which is carrying primary oocyte with a layer of granulosa cells and this structure will be called as primary follicle. So the number of primary follicles in the female during its birth is fixed. Now this primary follicle from birth till puberty, there are so many primary follicles in lakhs, but when the puberty is attained, when they have to convert it into secondary follicle, that time they has to be, some of them will be degenerated. Only 60,000 to 80,000 primary follicles will be left in the ovary. Means the oogonia which are formed in the ovary after birth, they will not be no new oogonia will be formed after birth, and the primary follicles present in the female ovary at the puberty, the number of primary follicles is fixed. We can detect them, that how many eggs will be formed in the further life of the reproductive life of the female, because the primary oocytes, the primary follicles has their fixed number. Now this primary oocyte will be converted into secondary follicle. Now what is the difference between primary and secondary follicle? The secondary follicle has secondary oocyte in it with the coverage of so many granulosa cells. Means here the granulosa cells will be increased, and in the center the secondary oocyte will have a layer of granulosa cells around it, and these cells will be arranged in such a way so that this cavity will be formed in the secondary follicle. Now this secondary follicle will be converted into tertiary follicle. Now this detail will also discuss in menstruation cycle when we will study. So this secondary follicle will be converted into tertiary follicle. Now the cell is there, you can see this cell, can you see? This is the secondary oocyte, because it has been already developed from primary oocyte. So this is secondary oocyte, and these are the granulosa cells which are present around the secondary oocyte, and this structure is called as tertiary follicle with a cavity in the center. This cavity is called antrum. Is cavity ko hum kya bolte hain? Antrum. Now this tertiary follicle will be converted into one more mature follicle, which is called Graafian follicle. So this is called Graafian follicle. Now the difference between two is that the Graafian follicle has large antrum as compared to tertiary follicle. Now this Graafian follicle, at the time of ovulation, when we will study the menstruation cycle, then you will be more clear that ovulation is the release of ovum from the ovary into the fallopian tube. But we are using the term ovum, but actually it is a secondary oocyte, because as I told you, the secondary oocyte will be converted into ovum only at the time of fertilization. Before that, the structure or the cell which is released out from the ovary into the fallopian tube is actually the secondary oocyte, and this process is called as ovulation. So after ovulation, the dead cells will be left over in the Graafian follicle. Now this structure will be converted into corpus luteum, and this corpus luteum will be converted into corpus albicans. This structure we will discuss in menstruation cycle, then you will be more clear. So is it clear ki what is the main process? So the most important point is that the number of oogonia are fixed in the fetal life, the number of primary oocytes are also fixed at the time of birth, and at the time of puberty the primary oocytes number is also fixed, and this secondary oocyte is the stage at which the ovulation will takes place, and the ovum will be converted only at the time of this secondary oocyte will be converted into ovum only at the time of fertilization. So this is all about the process of oogenesis. Now let's see the structure of ovum, and then we will study the hormonal control, means how the hormones affect this process of oogenesis. So let's now see the hormonal control, means how the oogenesis process and development of the ovary or female reproductive system is under the control of hormones. So hypothalamus that is a part of the brain, it will stimulate the secretion of GnRH, that is gonadotropin releasing hormone, that we have already done in case of spermatogenesis. So it will cause a positive feedback on anterior lobe of pituitary gland. So it will stimulate anterior lobe of pituitary gland, and on the onset of puberty, this GnRH secretion will be increased. And this will cause the increased stimulation of anterior lobe of pituitary gland. Now, this pituitary gland will release two hormone, LH and FSH. Same that hormones that were secreted by in case of spermatogenesis, luteinizing hormone, and FSH is follicle stimulating hormone. Now, these two hormones will stimulate ovary to LH hormone is basically responsible for ovulation to release ovum. And FSH is follicle stimulating hormone. So it will stimulate more and more primary follicles to undergo development, to release, to secrete or to synthesize ovum. And also these two hormones will help in the release of the female sex hormones, that is estrogen and progesterone. So estrogen and progesterone, they plays an important role in menstrual cycle. Like the estrogen will help the uterus to develop the endometrium lining for menstruation or for the nourishment of the growing fetus, and progesterone also. So both of these hormones, they play an important role in the development of the uterus. And progesterone, estrogen is also responsible for developing the secondary sexual character in females. And progesterone is also called as pregnancy hormone that will maintain the pregnancy after fertilization. So, is it clear? So, these are the hormones that control the oogenesis process in females. So, let's now see the structure of ovum or an oocyte. Actually, the ovum is the central part, the central cell or female gamete. This whole structure at which the ovulation will take place is called as oocyte. As you know, it is in the secondary oocyte phase. So, this oocyte, which is released at the time of ovulation from the ovary, has this structure. So here you can see in the center there is a cell. The cytoplasm enclosed in the ovum is called ooplast, and like a normal cell, its membrane is called plasma membrane, and in the center it has a nucleus. Now this layer you can see here, the layer which I have drawn is called zona pellucida. And outside the zona pellucida, the cells, where you can see these cells are this, they will form a layer called corona radiata. And actually these corona radiata cell are follicular cells. Means, did you remember the structure, the graafian follicle in which the secondary oocyte was surrounded by some cells to protect them? And when the graafian follicle will release this oocyte, it will be in this stage. So, some of the cells of follicles will retain around the secondary oocyte, and this whole structure is considered as a secondary oocyte, okay? Because these cells, the follicular cells which are present around the ovum or secondary oocyte is called zona pellucida. And this is just for the protection, and as well as zona pellucida, they both will play the role of protection, because the ovum has to move from ovary towards the fallopian tube to reach the ampulla part of the fallopian tube to ready itself for fertilization. This zona pellucida, it is a layer of thick material which is secreted by follicular cells. Now this zona pellucida, it will retain outside the secondary oocyte till the fertilization takes place. If the sperm reaches the ovum or the secondary oocyte, it has to break the zona pellucida to enters into the ovum, okay? So did you remember the acrosome? Acrosome was there over the head of the over the tip of the head of the sperm, that was containing some hydrolytic enzymes. That enzymes were actually for degrading this zona pellucida, so that this can be degraded and the sperm can enter into the nucleus of the sperm can enter into the secondary oocyte or ovum. So when this it will be in the stage of secondary oocyte till the ovum will reach to the, till the sperm will reach to the ovum. So if you are asked to draw the diagram of ovum or oocyte, you don't have to confuse, you will draw the same. The ovum structure is this, as well as the secondary oocyte structure is this. So with this, we are finished with oogenesis. Next, we'll take up menstruation cycle in detail.